Welcome back to another episode of Wild North Addiction. I'm going to keep this super short because I'm blown away about where we are right now. And believe it or not, we're camping right there. Right there. So no mucking around. We're going to get this gear off the boat and set up camp. Right, the gear's off the boat. Now we're gonna go and anchor the boat. And I didn't bring a paddleboard or a kayak. So you know what that means. It means I have to get wet and go and anchor this bad boy out there. Oh, it's gonna be cold. Now it's time to jump in the middle of winter. I'm such a wuss when it comes to this sort of stuff. I hate jumping in when it's cold. And I can't let you guys get wet because there's a microphone. Oh, holy moly, it's cold. See you later, Free Willis. Oh, that was refreshing. It's actually not as bad as I thought, but it's still bloody cold. So we've got a bommie. There's a few little rocks just in here. That's why I didn't park my boat a little bit closer. Just wanted to be safe than sorry. I don't want my boat end up smashing on the rocks at some ridiculous hour in the morning, because I've already experienced that once and it is a bust up. How's this? This is such a sick little place. We'll go and set up camp, put the tent up, and then I've got a little something else to show you. So, let's go. Made it back to the beach. Free Willis is out there. Water's super clear. And we're gonna chuck the tent up there. This is epic. Setting up camp, I just thought I'd show you guys these new Just Another Fisherman duffel bags. So it's a new color and it's also got a hard bottom with non-slip things, and it is pretty much completely waterproof. So I got the hose, squirted it, gave it a real good soaking, and no water. Well, a few dribbles got in, but hardly any water got in, so it's pretty much waterproof, which is absolutely epic. And Just Another Fisherman, Angler Tech backpack. So that's just the new color. Put all my clothes, all my stuff that can't get wet in there. Like I've got my tent, my sleeping bag, everything pretty much I need for camping, it's in there. So shout out to Jeff, bloody good. How sick is this? Got the tent right there and the little posse. Boat out there.
and chili bins, draft bags, gear. Now for gear, we've only got the Saltiga and the little Daiwa soft bait set. So a stick bait set and a soft bait. So
actually the plan is now, is you guys are gonna watch a little clip from the other day of me catching my first topwater kingfish, which I'm very stoked about. It went 21 kg, and for the fight we were stick baiting along. I was with Andre Dreefish and Blake Hay, good mate of mine, both good mates of mine. Thought, oh well, we'll go out for a bit of a stick bait. I didn't really not want to go, but I wasn't really a stick baiter. I was like, okay, yeah, I'll go. So I've actually got Joe Wild's old stick bait set. It's way too big for me, but when you hook that big fish, then it's good. So anyway, we're stick baiting along, casting. I was bored as. Next minute, casted it out, did like one pop, and then boomfa, this kingfish come and ate it. And it ate it so hard that it choked it, and it didn't really fight. So as soon as I hooked this fish, Andre put the boat into gear to get out of there, because we were over some reef, shallow reef, like 10, 15 meters. And my drag was so tight, because I didn't want to lose a kingie to get to the bottom. My drag was so tight that the kingfish actually started skipping behind the boat, like we were just skip baiting for marlin, like it was loose. It was come up to the surface, it was thrashing its head around, and I pretty much just wound it in. So I'll play these clips now. Thank you guys for tuning in already. Stay around because you're going to want to see this. And then we're going to go and try and catch some dinner. So stick around, hope you guys like it. Let's go.
Oh, he's a good fish, man. He choked it too, right? He is a nice one, man. He just wrestles it in on his fucking feet. He choked it, that's why he doesn't fight. He's a good fish, Willie. Yeah, bro. Watch out, he doesn't get you in the motor, bro. He's not done yet, man.
A quick cunt, eh? How big's that?
That's a good fish, brother. That's like, oh, you have 14 kilos, 15 kilos. It's a good fish. He just doesn't fight because he choked the lure. Just hold him there, bro. Fuck yes, bro.
Big dog.
Is that how they fight them in the far north? Just next to the boat.
Yeah,
I think he needs to come home. He's bleeding, bro. Don't grab him yet, Blake. He's fucking green, eh? Should we get him?
Yeah, we have to get.
Just take the rubber thing off. Alright. Careful, careful. Sir, lots of grunt, eh? He's a big fish, so they jump out of the way once you have him. Don't get in the trace. Holy shit balls. He choked it too, eh? Nice. That's a big fish, bro. Fuck off. Get out of the way, Blake. Get out of the way. Watch out for the trebles. Watch out for the trebles. Bro, that is a big fish. That is a big fish. That is close to like, that's 80, 90 kilos, bro.
Big corner.
Oh my god, and he choked that lure, eh? Right. You take him home, mate.
Yeah.
Hey?
Yeah. Fuck you, boy.
Fuck me, bro. That's a slop, bro. That could be very close to 20 kilos, mate.
Yeah.
That was the size of mine there. Went higher yesterday.
Okay.
Holy, and it didn't even, because yeah, it, when they choke it, they don't go, bro.
They already
were dragging him behind the boat.
Because I was saying the splash was like massive.
Yeah.
Fuck off, bro.
Big dog.
Yeah.
Nice work, brother.
Yeah, boy.
Bit of a bummer we can't release him, but well, he's gonna get eaten and consumed by the tribe, eh?
Yeah, hey. I'll feed him to the whānau.
Holy yeah, shit, that's a biggie, man.
He's shot straight into the smoker.
Fuck off. Hey, that's a big fish, bro. That's a fucking biggie, eh? Oh my god, he's
bait fishing. We're bait fishing.
That's your first one on the top water too, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, lure's out. I don't think we should put him back, eh?
Nah, we won't. Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, true. Fuck off. Oh, struggle is real, you reckon?
Right. So that's my first top water kingy. And what is it, about 20 kilo?
Something like that.
So, that's an absolute dog.
You gotta give a shout out to Dreyfish Adventures, mate.
Yeah, Andre, he's a charter fisherman now. Bloody good. Right, let's go catch a 20 pound snap.
Alright.
So, I'm sure you guys can see what I mean about that fish eating the lure so hard that it just comes straight to the surface. So that was a PB for me. I was pretty stoked about that. And now we're gonna go and catch some dinner. So I actually didn't bring any food. And as you guys know, I'm not the biggest cook. So we have white bread and butter with fish on bread and butter. We've got butter this time. It's probably a bit old, but it should be right. So yeah, we're gonna have a little walk around these rocks. We've got the Ocean Angler V2, Daiwa Sole, 2,500 with some Z-Man soft baits. And we're gonna chuck a bit more gear in that Jeff backpack and go for a walk around these rocks here. And it's actually not a bad fish. I know it's just fighting a little bit harder, but check that out. How sick is that? First fish. That is a beautiful snapper. And that was literally first cast. As soon as I got here, I just chucked one in the middle of this big open gut. And we're already catching snappers. So this is first fish. I'm gonna let him go and try and persevere and get another one. That's plenty for dinner, but it's first fish. So I'm gonna let him go.
Oh.
Oh, I'll leave the camera going this time. Oh, yes. So many fish here. It's two fish, two casts. This one's not a very big one. He's still legal, but that is not legal in Northland standards. Oh shit. Sorry mate, he's gone. Technically, we basically already got our feed, but we let the dog go.
know what quite happened there. I had a fish on and then I was winding it in and then I had another fish off. And there we have it. I think that is the perfect candidate for our dinner tonight. He's going straight on the cob grill. Big teeth too. Little fish, maybe around 40 centimeters. And I'm gonna give him an icky and chuck him straight in this backpack. I'm not gonna chuck him in here, but I've got some clothes in there and that'll be bust up, so I'm gonna carry him back. We've got dinner sorted. That was not hard at all. I thought that was gonna be a lot harder, to be honest. And well, I'm definitely not complaining. There's another one. I just had to do one more flick on the way home. Nice little panny. It's probably a little bit bigger than the other one, but we're gonna let him go. Right, now we're going home. So we've sort of got our own filleting bench here. It's actually bloody good. So I'm gonna fill it up with a snapper, put it on the cob chopping board, get the cob going, have a feed, fish on bread with heaps of butter, then get the fire going and go to bed. Chuck it straight down here. Right, there's our two fillets there. We'll give them a wash and chuck them on the cob grill. And that will feed me for tonight. One fish. Cob grill, such an awesome little portable cooker. Comes in this big ass bag. Got the lid. That's the cooker bit there. Just the gas. And then you screw this in. Then it's ready to go. It's as easy as that. It's so bloody good. All right, here we go. Got some butter here. It's mega moldy and it stinks, but it should be right. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. So we should be fine. Chuck heaps of that on. That's actually well past its use by date, but
Oh well. Wait for that to warm up and then we'll just chuck these fish on straight into bread, white bread. And there we go, that's my dinner. Oh, and you can't forget the tartare sauce. Right, she's really going now. So it's time to put the fish on. That butter's a little bit burnt and it's a bit hot. But we're on minimum, so should be right. As you guys can probably tell, this is not a cooking show. This is just Big Willis in his fine element. Having bust up after bust up. This is not a cooking show. Just enough for me to have a feed, fuel the machine, and then get back to it. And it's gonna be enough for me to keep me going for the rest of the day and a little bit of tomorrow. Can definitely say tartare sauce is butter, works bloody good. That's nearly better than butter for the bread anyway. Can definitely taste that off butter, but other than that I'm starving, so I'm not complaining one little bit. So nice. Now I'm gonna go and find some firewood. As you can see, there is no shortage of it along this mini beach, and we're gonna start a little fire. And that kingy on top water, that's pretty bloody cool. I'm pretty happy with it. So now we're just chilling, we've got the fire going, and now we're just chilling out. I'm about to do some editing, might run to the top of the hill for the sunset, and I'll see you on the next episode in the morning. Cheers guys.